Hey everybody, Tony D and Little Joan here with a screenwriter's rant on Don't Worry, Darling, starring Harry Styles, Chris Pine, Nick Kroll, Olivia Wilde. There's Harry Styles. Where's his dress? Smash like and subscribe. Thank you for smash liking and subscribing. Please check out my books. Links in the description. Comedy Horror in South Jersey. It's the Pineys. Or if you'd rather spend some money on some charity, my cousin's GoFundMe page link is below. The family's trying to raise money for his kidney transplant and that of his son. His son's already had it. Now they're trying to pay for it. And then they're trying to get one for his. I gotta admire anybody who gives up a kidney for another person. I mean, it's big. Anyhow, this movie, it's based, I don't know on what, but it's about a 50s housewife who's living a wonderful life with Harry Styles, and they have a great life, but she doesn't know what her husband does exactly, and they work on something called the Victory Project, which is like some kind of utopian community. And then there's some terrible secret behind it. They don't give you any kind of hint in the trailer what the secret is about. So I don't know what this movie is. So there's a secret, and then a bunch of the wives kill themselves or do weird things, and she has lots of sex with Harry Styles. And then, I don't know, bodies get dragged around, and Chris Pine plays the creepy head of the company, I guess. And Harry Styles keeps saying, "Oh, we could lose our fabulous life, honey." And, "No, I must know the truth." And Olivia Wilde smokes cigarettes. And here she is witnessing one of the wives commit suicide. And they have big parties and live fabulous lives. But it's all a sham. I don't know what the sham is, okay? For a couple of minutes, I thought, oh, maybe this is like kind of a weird version of the Stepford Wives, but because then she tries to escape. And then here's a scene where, I don't know, I guess she sees what the big secret is. I assume the entire movie hinges on that secret, which is why they're not showing me. So yeah, everybody's in this movie. Florence Pugh, Harry Styles, Olivia Wilde, who I think directs this. I believe so. I've got the IMDb out. Yeah. She directs it, too. Writers Katie Silberman, would it be Silberman, Carrie Van Dyke, and Shane Van Dyke. I wonder if they're related to Dick Van Dyke. Possibly. Probable. So a big cast of beautiful people wearing period clothing. What do I think of this movie? I don't know what the F it is. In theaters in September... September 23rd. I think it's weird that... Oh, here's the credits here. Story by Carrie Van Dyke, Shane Van Dyke, and Katie Silberman. Screenplay by Katie, directed by Olivia Wilde. Rated R. I don't know what the movie's about. Yeah, it takes place in the 50s. So do lots of movies. Yeah, it's about an unsatisfied housewife. There's a scene where she crushes the egg and there's nothing in the egg. Not sure what that's about. Maybe she's a robot? I don't know. I mean, tell us, what the hell is a movie about? Is this just another slam against traditional values? Is that where it's going? Because look, nobody can relate to this anymore. Like back in the 80s when they did these movies, there were still people alive, you know, who remember the 50s and lived in it. Most of those people are gone now, you know? To remember the 50s, you gotta be like old. You gotta be really old. I don't remember the 50s. I grew up in the 70s. I was born in the 60s. I mean, who the hell's gonna relate to this movie? I don't get it. Like, what the hell? Okay, sure. There's lots of movies that take place in World War II and in this time period, but, you know, the further you get away from it, it's like, the less people can relate to it. So what the hell is this movie? Harry Styles, okay, he's in it. So what? He's not an actor. He's a singer, I guess. I don't know. I'm not into his music. Nick Kroll's a comedian. He's in it. I don't know why. Chris Pine's an actor. I know him. I don't know her, but she looks okay. She looks like she's doing her job. Olivia Wilde, I'm sorry. She was, I believe it was her. She was in Cowboys and Aliens, right? Let me make sure she was in that. She was in Cowboys and Aliens, right? That terrible, terrible movie. I think that was him or her. Let me just see. Cowboys and Aliens. Cowboys and Aliens. Yep, there it is. That movie sucked. And she sucked in it. And when I say she sucked, she was like a wooden piece of cardboard in it. And she's good looking. Don't get me wrong, she's good looking. But can she direct? I don't know. I haven't seen a movie where she can act. So, I mean, I'll look at the credits. Let me see if there's anything Olivia Wilde's been in that I liked. All right, let's go back a ways. I don't know any of these. Year One, no, that sucked. I hated that. Tron Legacy, brutal. Cowboys and Aliens, no. In Time, I don't. That sounds vaguely familiar. She was on House. Tron Uprising. Her. Didn't see that. American Dad. Probably saw that. Portlandia. She was in Vinyl, that TV series about records in the 70s. That was kind of okay. I didn't really watch much of it. BoJack Horseman. She had a voice in that. I mean, Ghostbusters Afterlife, she was uncredited as Gozer. Interesting. But yeah, I mean, she hasn't been in anything that I really enjoyed or thought was good. And the one thing I remember her from, I thought she was terrible in. Just absolutely terrible. So, I mean, good on her getting a directing gig. It's not easy to get. But, I mean, the look of the movie's good. It looks kind of like the 50s, and they've got gentle music playing, and is it good? I don't know what the movie's about. I can't tell you if it's good. I can tell you it looks okay. Chris Pine comes off as Chris Pine does. But, like, the substance isn't here. I need something to sink my teeth in to say, okay, this is going to be a horrible revelation that it's supernatural, that it's science-based, you know, some kind of sci-fi angle, or that it's based on history, it's something that they're going to show me, and that was real, that it was based on a true story, something. Was it based on a book? I mean, what the hell is the story? These kind of trailers piss me off. Now, the whole movie hinges on the big disturbing, it says disturbing secrets, plural, so I assume there's more than one. I mean, are they just polluting the atmosphere? What the hell are they doing? What the hell could they be doing? I don't know. I assume they're in LA. There's palm trees in the shots, right? So you gotta assume it's like in LA somewhere, or somewhere near, there's the palm trees in the background. Maybe Florida. I mean, what could they be doing in the 50s that's so evil that you'll just be horrified by the revelation? Does this take place in an alternate United States? I mean, all those concepts to me are a bit intriguing, but I don't know. I don't know if any of those concepts apply here. So what the hell am I supposed to get out of this trailer? Oh, there's beautiful people in it that you sort of kind of know. It's directed by a woman who you didn't like. In a movie, I can't even do the three-act breakdown. I don't know what the F the movie's about. I could guess that, like, first act, they have a fantastic life. Harry Styles gets a new job. They get married. They move to this community, or they're already married. They're having a fantastic life, and then weird stuff starts happening. She wants to know what this new job is, why he got this job. Chris Pine is creepy and weird. They go to parties. Everybody just tells her to, like, enjoy her life and shut up. She can't do it. She keeps digging, keeps digging. People kill themselves. Finally, she finds out in the top of the end of the second act, and then now she wants to leave and get the hell out. I guess that's a possibility. See, like, if this is some kind of weird alternate Earth where, like, you know, outside is a vast wasteland and the whole, I don't know, the whole society's just a big scam or grift or whatever, and it only exists in a certain part. I mean, that ain't gonna work. So she wants to leave and go where? Is what part? Is this real? I mean, what the hell is it? What's this trailer supposed to do? I'm supposed to trust you, Hollywood? I'm supposed to trust there's a story here? You're not telling me what the story is. I mean, what's her character arc? Did she discover some horrible secret? Okay. That's like 99% of the movies. People discover stuff. There are revelations in every freaking movie. Okay? You know, I just looked at the revenge movie. What did they discover? Well, the guy's daughter was killed. He discovers it, the revelation is who killed his daughter. And then the discovery for Bruce Willis is he discovers the guy who killed his son, and they just go at it. I mean, I need something here. You know, it's not enough for music and Harry Styles to be in something for me to go, oh yeah, I'll watch that movie. And you could say, well, it's not really aimed at you. Who the hell's it aimed at? It takes place in the 50s, dude. 50s. You got to be like 100 to go, oh, I remember the 50s. So that's not going to appeal to an audience. They can't relate to it, right? The time of cigarettes and booze. And so it's probably going to be a caricature of the 50s anyway, right? It's going to be a Hollywood caricature where the men are, oh, the men do everything, and they're a bunch of sexist misogynists, and, you know. I mean, why would Hollywood even make this movie now? They got to deal with that kind of stuff. What, you know, and the racism and whatever. And then there's at least one black couple in the trailer, so what's the deal there? What's the deal there? Is this like a perfect utopia where racism didn't happen and misogyny doesn't happen, but it took place in the 50s somehow? What is it? I'm very annoyed that I don't know. It seems like they spent a lot of money to just tease me with something I don't care that much about. You know, if you tease me about something I don't know, like I have no idea what this movie's about, and you just tease me, what are you teasing me with? Nothing. I don't know. Ooh, we've got something. What? Anyhow, that's it for me, Tony D. I'm sorry. I'm a little cranky. I guess I'm a little cranky, Joan. Maybe I need a nap. So thank you for the person who suggested this one. Thank you, Jacob McDonald. I'm sorry I didn't like the trailer. Sometimes I'm just a cranky old man, Jacob. But thank you for the suggestion. I mean, I try to be positive, but it's just very frustrating when you don't know the story. I'm a writer. I want to know the story. I don't want to know the ending. I just want to know, give me a hint of what the dark revelation is. And if that hinges the whole movie, I don't know, man. I don't think that's going to be enough for people to go see this, right? I don't think it's going to be enough. Let's say in that scene where she goes up to the windows and looks out and it's horrified, she sees, I don't know, a field of bodies. Even that is going to be kind of like, okay, they killed people? I mean, that's a revelation, I guess. That's a disturbing secret, I guess. But, you know, it's got to be, I think in a period piece like this, it's got to be specific to something, right? Or it's got to be so mind-blowing and go, wow. But I don't think there's enough ground here. There's not enough grounded reality to blow my mind. I don't know where I am. I don't know where I am. Anyhow, that's it for me, Tony D and Little Joan. Check us out on Odyssey, BitChute, and Rumble for our more base takes, including a Hollywood hot take and a news blast. We'll see you tomorrow.